Why work with a spirit from a closed practice when you can just work with the cat? He knows so much. This cat, specifically. Tell them your secrets. Tell them the gospel. Thank you. Who let you on this fucking app? Who let you speak? Welcome to my new little series where I go outside, pick up an object, and tell you how to do a spell with it. Today's object is a rock. First, find the one you like. I liked this one. And then you're just going to bless the rock and ask it to help you in the spell that you wish. I asked this one for protection of my property. You can also anoint it or draw a sigil on it with a certain oil or water. I used wine. And then I just set it outside my door. I'll reactivate it as necessary, and yeah.
No, Garfield, the cable's out.
What's wrong with this thing?
Did you hear what I said? The cable's out.
Maybe it needs new batteries.
Garfield, listen to me carefully. The cable is out.
The cable?
I feel like a lot of times people feel like messages from your spiritual team or spirit guides are super, super clear. When in reality, it goes a lot like this. Something is coming. What's coming? Something. I'll be honest, I am not someone who tends to blame the planets or the moon for things that happen in my life that I'm upset with. But this week, if I see the Aries full moon, I'm gonna beat it up. Me and the Aries full moon are at war this week. If I see that bad boy in the sky at any point, I'ma start throwing things at it. I don't care. I'ma curse it. I don't care.
It's the little girl who lives at the plaza in New York.
I'm Eloise! I'm 6 and I just shit in the hallway!
You get to choose the carving tool. Which one? That's a dull one, so choose a different one. That's also a dull one, choose a different one. Or that's a completely different object, it works. To get one of, over there are my oils, I need you to get success oil for me.
Are you gonna watch me do this before you tell me which one it is?
I don't know which one it is. It has a tag on it. You want some success oil? Light this and we're going to say a prayer together to Saint Joseph. Blessed Saint Joseph, we ask for your blessing and your protection and your assistance in receiving the house on. We really love this house. We think it would make a great place for a home. And if you help us in our petition, we will give you
a seven-day candle.
And glass of wine. Thank you, Saint Joseph.
Thanks.
And we'll know tomorrow if this works.
Sunny day.
Benji.
Ethan.
What?
The veil is thin.
I don't know what that means.
It's time to commune with the land spirits.
Squirrels?
Yeah.
That's me in the corner. That's me in the spotlight. Losing my religion.
Throughout my time as a witch and a spiritual practitioner, I have felt like I've met animals like pets or dogs or cats that just are ancient. They just know things. They feel almost like human in a weird way. And then there's Benji, who is completely content to be concerned with the ball and not the secrets of the universe. He's giving me a tarot reading. He doesn't read tarot. Give me a nice past, present, future reading.
So our first card is the star, and it is upside down. Mm-hmm. You were probably Satan. Present is of cups.
Ten. That's a ten of cups.
Ten cups.
Yeah.
I think you are probably going to get shithouse drunk pretty soon off of like 10 cups of Jaeger or something. And your future is the
eight
of swords reversed. And so eight people are gonna come after you and accuse you of not being a real witch. And you're going to reverse that on them by casting a spell that turns them all into swords.
My son is a spiritual healing at the ribbon for your feelings. The way she said, my son is a spiritual healing.
Who's this?
Mike.
What's his name?
Mike.
Please, I'm absolutely fine. There is nothing to worry.
Do you wear wigs?
No, I do not.
Have you worn wigs?
No, I have not.
You are a beautiful man. A beautiful man. Will you wear wigs?
Maybe.
When will you wear wigs? Mr. Wilson.
Prime example of the kind of people that follow key guidance. They're not only racist, but also anti-Semitic.
Before watching my video, you should go watch Hecatean Foodies and Keys's video. But all I'm going to say is that if your commenters are actively spewing racist rhetoric and actively misgendering someone who gently approached you with a criticism, you need to rethink how you are utilizing your platform right now. Hi, I'm Frankie, and if you're a non-witch dating a witch, here are a few little secrets. Here is a list of deities that if they worship or work with them, don't fuck with their feelings. Your life will be ruined. How many tarot decks do they own? If it's more than six, you will never be able to lie to them. Never. You can't keep any secrets. They will know. What does their altar look like if you've seen it? If it has a lot of wax strips on it or it's a little messy, they may forget things sometimes. How many candles do they have? If they have a lot of candles, do they have a fire extinguisher nearby? If not, that is an accident waiting to happen, and so is the relationship. If you find a jar full of stuff, looks a little spooky, don't fucking touch it. Just don't. Don't touch it. What do they smell like? What does their room smell like? That tells you a lot about what they consistently need in their life. People always ask me if people's entities, deities, demons, saints, etc. show up when I do a reading for someone who works with them. The answer is yes. If they don't show up to communicate with me medium-wise, they will show up in the cards. Here are some of the more intense and like overwhelming ones where they didn't just show up in the cards, they were in my room being like, hi, can you tell them this? Zeus, he doesn't fuck around. Loki. And Morgan, of course. Santa Muerte was recently. That was an experience. Hermes, once, I think. Lucifer, like the, not the Arabian Lucifer, but like the morning star, fallen angel Lucifer. And there are definitely more that I like can't think of off the top of my head. Today I am talking about red flags in witchcraft books that I look for. That immediately make me put down the book and not recommend them. One, slurs. I don't care, slurs. If you're using a slur, why? Two, recommending books out of closed initiatory practices without a warning that you shouldn't work with them unless you're initiated. Personally, I don't think you should even be writing on them if you're not a part of that practice, but some people are like, oh, they put a disclaimer, I guess it's okay. Three, saying it's okay to use white sage and Palo Santo when many indigenous folks have asked people who are not indigenous not to use them. Done. Four, using terms like black magic, white magic. Do not like it. We'll put it down. Five, treating like the Wiccan read applies to all witches. Absolutely not. It comes from Wicca. Not everyone abides by it.
Poop. Little cleanse of self.
Just in case.
Good day, I'm Bob the Necromancer, and today we're doing an unboxing.